In the United States, garlic has been popular since the 1920s. In recent times, it's been the subject of trade wars and a commodity boom-bust cycle. Right now, about 3/4 of the world's supply of garlic comes from China. China is the world's leading exporter of garlic. There is garlic grown in the United States, mostly in California, but about half of the costs of growing that garlic are labor costs. And of course, labor is much cheaper in China, which means that for the most part, Chinese garlic is much cheaper than American garlic. China has won many export markets for garlic around the world by supplying a cheaper product. California farmers have lobbied the U.S. government for tariffs and trade restrictions on Chinese garlic, but they haven't been able to get what they wanted. In the country of Ireland, however, there is a very high import duty on garlic. It's at 232%. There's a well-known recent legal case where an importer was shipping garlic into Ireland, and he labeled it as apples because the import duty on apples was only 9%. He was caught, and he will be going to jail. Of course, this makes for a higher price of garlic in Ireland. The boom-bust cycle for garlic started around the time of the financial crisis. The demand for garlic dipped suddenly in 2008 when many countries went through a recession. In response, Chinese farmers planted about 50% less garlic than they had the year before. It turned out this was an overreaction, and in 2009 the demand for garlic came back stronger than had been anticipated. On top of this, there was a rumor that garlic would protect individuals against swine flu. That made the demand for garlic even stronger. At a national level, suddenly the price of garlic rose by a factor of 4 in China. In a number of cities, it rose by a factor of 10, and in one garlic-growing region, it actually rose by a factor of 40, very briefly. At the time, this was called the garlic bubble. The history of garlic markets illustrates the general benefits of free trade, trade in agricultural products as an engine of economic growth, but it also shows that this path can be a volatile one. For more information on garlic markets, simply Google Economics of Garlic.